For me to be able to walk into a farmer's farm with no announcement, it gives me confidence. When you know the whole story from where that pig's come from, if you follow that story from the piglet all the way through to the farm, and you know it's going to a good abattoir, a good butcher, coming into your kitchen in a good quality state, you're going to take as much care as that as you are going to take a loaf of bread. I was fortunate enough after the first 8 months of working in a pub restaurant, a local chef called Rob Kennedy asked if I needed a bit of support and really took me under his wing, offered me a role in Sandhurst. And it was incredible. You cooked everything from your cadets on a daily basis to royalty, delegates of different countries. It was fantastic. I teach many, many chefs who come work for me. It doesn't matter who you cook for or what you're cooking for, the standards should always be the same. So today I'm using a pork Henry, which is not really used that much in the industry. And the key part for me is how can we use a whole pig? And we're cutting carcasses up for no need sometimes. So taking this cut, there's less prep, there's less time, and it's less wastage. And it works all the way through the chain, from farmer to consumer. Having a good relationship with my suppliers is key that I get that pork Henry. And that comes from the shoulder of the pork. And then I'm going to do that with a caramelised mashed potato, serve it with some heritage carrots, a parsnip fillet puree and 10 stem broccoli. The beauty that I've got a pork and apple dish, but no visual side of apple on the plate. I'm a lover of cider and we've got many apples on site here, so I tend to make the most of those. And I've left that pork Henry in cider for 7 days. The sugars of that cider will break down that fat content, give it even a better flavour. The mashed potato, I'm going to caramelise some smoked garlic. I'm going to take some banana shallots, slowly caramelise those on a low heat. Whilst that's happening, I've got potatoes on the boil. I'm going to take those off, we'll mash them, and then mash them again, and then pass them through a fine sieve so I get the best quality mash. I take it to a point where I can just about pass a skewer through the potatoes, and therefore I haven't cooked all of that potato through. And where they're left, they steam a little bit and I get the fluffiest mashed potato. For the shallots and garlic, we're then gonna puree that and mix that slowly into the mashed potato. And while that's going on, we're just gonna cook some carrots in a little bit more cider. And then we're just gonna roll those into a dry pan and caramelize those as well. And then we're just gonna blanch some 10 stem broccoli, saute that off with a little bit of pepper, and it will come onto the plate. Key part is knowing where your meat's come from. I've got a really good relationship with not just my butcher, but the farmer. So I have the best pork coming to my kitchen, and there's no doubt about it. I remember my first visit to the farm that I used, and I heard stories about this farm, and I was like, I've got to go see him. And when I turned up, I knew immediately by the way they spoke about the science that's involved on the farm, and what they do to create the best marbling. They care about where their meat ends up. And then we went to see the pigs after passing so many fields that they plant seeds just for wildlife. And you get that real buzz that they just don't care about the financial side. They care about the environment. East Anglia is struggling with wildlife, and they're putting back into the farm. They can make another use for it and make another financial gain from it, and they don't. And then we went onto the farm, and just casually both of them walked into the pens, and the pigs just love rubbing up against them. You can see that they were happy pigs. If you've got an unhappy animal, and the slaughtering process also is an unhappy experience, the muscle that you're going to have from the animal is going to be a lower grade by far. If we've got happy animals all the way through, even to killing process and into my kitchen, that flavour is going to go so far. And as chefs, we'll have to do less work to create that flavour.